Now, God did this not by accident, but on purpose. The word of God separates the wheat from the tare. Those who are of God, those who are not of God, the word of God will clearly define it. When we are separated, those who do not want to have fellowship with us, we're to leave them alone.
That's right.
I didn't write the word. And true light is defending the faith once together. Not him. If we are the true light, and we are, let's not try to find ways to compromise just a little bit. If you're going to compromise over here, might as well compromise over here. Then what have you got? You got the same thing that the secular churches have. That's a compromised church, which is not of God. Verse 16.
They profess that they know God.
They say they know God. They say that they're saved.
But in works, they deny Him.
But in their actions of life, it don't bear up to the word of God. Their testimony is not for real. Bible says they went out from us, but they were not of us. Had they been of us, they would have remained with us. But they went out that it might be made manifest that they were not all of us. So when we see that we have, let me go into some deep water here.
Take your time, Mom.
Separation means separation. You can't identify with those who do not want to be a part of us. There's no two ways you can do it. There's no simple way. There's no way that you can mix it in together and it'll come out right at the end. If they are not of us, we ought to leave them alone until they decide to be a part of us. Now, it hurts sometimes when you go into immediate family values. I know. I've been there. I ain't telling you to do something I don't know about. But when I found out this, when so-called loved ones do not want to be a part of you because of your religious stand, then don't be a part of them because of your religious stand. Don't try to have it both ways. I wish that you could, but you can't. God created a divided people by His word, and the word will separate those who say they're of God and those who say they are of God but are not. It says in verse 16, they profess that they know God,
but in words they deny Him, being abominable and disobedient.
You're disobedient when you don't want to follow Bible instruction.
That's right.
Paul said it's the doctrine that saves us. Instructions are found in the doctrine. The doctrine teaches how to act, how to live, how to walk. If the doctrine teaches us that, then it's for a people to obey that. We did not make God, God made us. God's not to follow us, we're to follow God. If it hurts, then you need to pray about it. You need to fast about it. And you need to make a conscious decision about it. You cannot please the world and yet please God. We go to Ypsilanti twice a year. We ask our relatives to come, be a part of us, just for a couple of hours. They say no. Why is this? They don't want to stoop to a level where they have to identify with a holiness church because that condemns them too much in their false spirit. When you invite loved ones to come and fellowship with you, see your relatives, see your grandchildren, your grandbabies, and they say no, there's something wrong when you still gravitate and reach out to them. Now you need to think about it. God did not make us weaklings. Because we're saved, we're not weaklings. Because we're saved, we're not nobody's fool. I learned before I ever got saved, if you don't want to have nothing to do with me,
that's right.
Bye. I don't want nothing to do with you. Why am I going to keep getting my feelings hurt and put myself in embarrassing positions when I know what you think of me?
That's
And if I represent the church of God, I'm going to keep my head up.
That's right.
I'm going to address God there, like God said in 1 Timothy 2 and 10. And if they resent how I look and how I act, and I know this in my heart, why do I want to be around them when I know what they really think of me? You can't live for your children. You can set an example for your children, but you cannot live for your children. You can only live for God and His kingdom. Let's make up our mind. We're going to be for real. There's one thing that is lower than a sinner, and that's somebody professing God but not living according to God. If you live according to God, then you have to conduct yourself as a vessel of God. To try to please the world and please God, that's a balancing act. And you can get your best high wire act, and he can get that pole or that umbrella, and he can balance all he wants. But you cannot balance the world and righteousness and make it come out in the end. It won't work out that way. I'm telling you, church, as your leader, don't try to have gatherings of the family when that is not your family. We have one family.
That's right.
And that's in holiness. This is your family. I am the spiritual father. I begot you by my gospel. Is that what Paul said? No. He said, to my own son in the gospel.
Yes.
Timothy. Yes. If Timothy was his son in the gospel, Paul had to be his father in the gospel.
Yes.
Hallelujah. A righteous lifestyle does not compromise, and it does not bring on a fakeness in the scripture. Let's not be a fake. You're for the church? Oh, yeah. Now, you just can't let people talk you into doing this or doing that, even though it may sound pleasurable. It's good to be around family members during certain holidays. But if your family members are not a part of your church family, how are they yet a family of yours? When God said, come out from amongst them and be separate and touch not the unclean thing. That's it. I can't change it because I didn't write it. But I got to teach it because I'm called of God. And you got to live it because you are obedient servants of the Lord. He never said it would be easy, did he? But he said you have to make a choice. Ephesians 5th chapter. Pick up verse 13.
But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light.
Anything that proves itself is proved by one thing, and that's the knowledge of God's divine truth. When God's truth comes to a people, it proves where you are in your relationship with the Lord. Read.
But whatsoever doth make manifest is light. Wherefore he said, awake thou that sleepest and arise from the dead.
If you sleep in church, you need to wake up. Now we had some pretty good praise service. Ain't nobody got no business when you sleep. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord, amen.
Preacher, I don't know, but I like where you're going tonight.
Go there, preacher.
I still love you.
Hallelujah.
And you still got to say amen.
Amen.
If I'm teaching the truth, you still got to say amen. Now, if I get away from the truth, stand up and say, wait a minute, preacher.
Hallelujah.